Hi there. Welcome back. Today we're going to take a look at profitability ratios. And in this particular video, we're going to look at gross profit margin. So without further ado, let's get started. Hi, everybody. Today in this video, we're going to talk through the gross profit margin. When we take a look at different ratios that we can do as far as analyzing a company and their financial stability, one of the things that we can look at is profitability. And the gross profit margin looks at how much money is left over from revenue after taking out the direct cost of goods sold. Cost of goods sold can also be found as cost of revenue. So if you look at a company's financial statement, if you look at their income statement on Yahoo Finance, then oftentimes you will not find a cost of goods sold. This is probably one of the hardest things that students of accounting find in ratio analysis, is because things are not named the same across companies often. So if you look at a company that you work for, and you look at their financial statements, you may not find a cost of revenue, but you would find a cost of goods sold. Just know that they are synonymous and they mean the same thing. The gross profit amount, once you calculate that, is then used to cover the general costs of running a business. And you'll see that when we talk a little bit about the net profit margin. Okay, so how to calculate gross profit margin? The numbers for this calculation will come off of the income statement. You will want to pull revenue, and sometimes you may see revenue shown on an income statement as sales. So sales and revenue, they're the same thing. And the cost of goods sold, or cost of revenue. Okay, so let's take a look at Brown-Forman Corporation. This is a company that I have been analyzing through all of the videos of ratio analysis, and we see that their income statement, their total revenue or total sales for 2014 were $2,991,000. And again, I want to point out that these numbers are in thousands, so that number actually is $2,991,000,000 is the total revenue. And then right underneath that, you'll see gross profit has already been calculated for you. You'll see the cost of revenue is there as well. And so the source for this is finance.yahoo.com. So let's take a look at Brown-Forman. And we look at their revenue and sales for the 3 years. So we'll take a look at 2014, 2013, and 2012. And you take the revenue or sales and divide that by the gross profit number. So for Brown-Forman in 2014, for every dollar that they generated in revenue, they were able to keep 69 cents of that dollar as gross profit. So Brown-Forman and the other companies that we're looking at in this ratio analysis, what they do is they sell spirits, they sell alcohol, and they distribute alcohol and things like that. So when we talk about cost of revenue can be things like the wine or the spirits that actually go into the bottle itself, the label that goes on the bottles, the shipping cost to actually distribute it or even get it to the factory before it gets filled with the alcohol, things like that. So we're looking at direct cost of sales that actually go into the production of the product or service. Now let's look at Diageo, one of their competitors. And as we've talked about before, even though Diageo is a much larger company in terms of revenue and sales, they have $17 billion, nearly $18 billion in sales in 2014. But comparatively, Brown-Forman and Diageo keep over 60 cents of every dollar in revenue that they generate. So we're starting to see a trend, which is probably a pretty good trend, as a matter of fact. And finally, our other company, our third company, Constellation Brands, they have a gross profit margin of around 40 cents. And you think to yourself, oh my goodness, okay, that's a little different. They are certainly not keeping 60 cents plus. They're only keeping 40 cents. Okay, so why would that be? And I actually looked this up. I went out and found their 10K that they submit to the Securities and Exchange Commission. And I searched on terms like cost of goods sold, product costs, things like that. And what came back is that they have some higher costs in their direct manufacturing and distribution, and they attributed it to the cost of glass for bottles. And finally, one of the things that helps a lot when you're doing ratio analysis, or it can help you to sort of see, you know, where a company may be different from some other company, is I also did a vertical analysis on these three companies based on just this ratio and the numbers that go into this ratio. And as you can see, the cost of revenue for Brown-Forman and for Diageo is roughly about the same. It's in the 30% range, where for Constellation Brands, their cost of revenue is more towards 59 to 60%, which is pretty large. And you'll see when we get to the net profit margin ratio that this can make a significant difference in the bottom line. So with that, I hope that this helps to see how a gross profit margin analysis can help you to understand the profitability of any company. And we'll be moving on to another video. Thank you.